Very good morning, students. Today we are going to see the next lesson, which is oscillations. Okay, and I think you know already with the oscillations, what is meant by oscillation is the to and fro motion. That is called as a oscillation. Yes. So based on this, first we are going to see with what is the periodic and non-periodic motion. Motion in physics can be classified as repetitive and non-repetitive. Okay, so repetitive is periodic, non-repetitive is non-periodic. So what is a periodic is any motion which repeats itself in a fixed interval of time. So after fixed interval of time, if any motion, if it is repeating, that is called as a periodic motion. We can say as the example, hands in the pendulum clock, swinging of a cradle, the revolution of earth around the sun, and waxing and waning of moon. So these are all the examples of periodic motion. Next is non-periodic. So it does not repeat itself, okay, which does not repeat itself after regular interval of time. This you can say as earthquake, volcano, so they all don't repeat, is it not? So these are all the non-periodic motion. Clear? Next is oscillatory motion. So what is meant by oscillatory is when a object or the particle move back and forth repeatedly for some duration of time. So back and forth, so front and back, okay, front as well as back. See here, so this is swing, so it is moving front then backward, then again it moves front, then again it moves backward. So this motion is called as a oscillatory motion. Same way this chair also, we can see this comes this side and here, okay, again it comes back, again it comes front, is it not? So this is all the oscillatory motion. Our heartbeat, swinging motion of wings of an insect, grandfather's clock, that is a pendulum clock. Okay, so not all the oscillatory are periodic, whereas all the periodic need not be oscillatory. Okay, so oscillatory ellame enadhu periodic dhaan, because it moves from one point to other, then again it repeats itself, then again it repeats. Okay, since it is repeating, is going on, it is called as a periodic. Okay, but all the periodic is not oscillatory. Okay, so oscillate ella periodic motion me vandu oscillatory motion a irukadhu. If you see the moving of the earth around the sun, okay, so this is the sun, earth is moving, so this is not oscillatory, because this is not to and fro motion, this is a circular motion. Clear? So next is an important term which we are going to see is simple harmonic motion. Simple harmonic motion is a type of oscillatory motion in which the acceleration or the force is directly proportional to its displacement. So this is the main thing in this. Okay, so in this we'll consider F to be the force, A to be the acceleration, and X to be the displacement. So according to simple harmonic motion, the acceleration is said to be directly proportional to the displacement. Okay, so simple harmonic motion is a special type of oscillatory motion in which what acceleration is directly proportional to its displacement. Okay, so acceleration is proportional to the displacement. Now to remove the proportionality, we'll be introducing a constant, is it not? So we are writing as equal to minus b, where b is said to be a constant. Okay, so why we are writing with a minus is because acceleration and the displacement are in the opposite direction, so we are writing as a minus. Okay, now same way we can also write this as write for by multiplying the mass on both the sides. Now both the sides if you multiply with the mass, so we can write this as A into m, which is equal to minus b m into x, because both the side we have multiplied the m. This is m into a, m into a is equal to what, f. Okay, which is equal to, instead of this bm, we are writing as k. Okay, that is a force constant, which is defined as force per unit length. Okay, so we are writing this as k and x. So f is equal to minus kx, and the negative sign indicates that displacement and the force. Here force and the displacement, they are in the opposite direction. Okay, clear? Now when the force or the acceleration will point towards the equilibrium, that is towards the right, so the force which restores, okay, so if this is a forward motion and if it comes again to the initial position, that is said to be what, the restoring force. Yes, clear with what is simple harmonic motion? Okay, so next is a projection of uniform circular motion on the diameter of SHM. Okay, so for this, consider a particle of mass m moving with a uniform speed v along the circumference in the anti-clockwise direction. So consider that any particle is moving in the anti-clockwise direction. Then let us assume it coincides with the origin at the center. Okay, so let O be the center of the circle. If omega is angular velocity and theta is angular displacement, then we can write theta is equal to omega into t, because that is the relation between linear and angular velocity, which is theta is equal to omega into t. Okay, so considering this to be the center and this has a radius r, okay, and this is said to be the distance x, okay, and this is said to be the distance y. So from this we are writing this to be theta. Okay, only we know with this value. Okay, from this if you write what is sin theta is equal to, yes, so sin theta is equal to what? Opposite divided by hypotenuse, is it not? And so this opposite I am writing as y, so y divided by r. From this you need the value of y alone, so y is equal to r into sin theta. Clear? So this is for this. Next is considering with the next value of cos theta. Yes, so what is the formula for cos theta? Which is equal to x divided by r. From this, if you need the value of x alone, say x is equal to r into cos theta. So these are the values, y is equal to r into sin theta, x is equal to r into cos theta. We are getting this from this triangle. Okay, clear? So when you see this pictures, we'll be clearly able to find out that when one oscillation is completed, one circular motion will be completed. Okay, so see here, at this position it is starting. Okay, so here it is moving on at this position. Okay, here again it is moving to P2. Okay, because it is moving in the circular path like this. Yeah, so appo inge or point, then inge, then here, after that here, here, and this point. So these are the points we are going to see. So ipa idhukku nama paathutom, ipa idhukku pathinga appadina idhukku nera indha direction la poiduchu. So inge irundhu konjam mele poiducha. Okay, again third one is at the top. Okay, so top it is going to the one end. Yes, then again coming to this point, so this point it comes down again. The next is here, inge enagum marubadiyum inge adum. Okay, then again at this point, sorry, this point it comes down, then this it comes over here, here it has been plotted here, then again to the first point, is it not? So when we take this as well as this, okay, so starting from here it comes over here, okay, then this point, then this point, then when we see here it is coming downwards again, then this point, this here, and again this to this point, again it is coming over here. So when it is completing one cycle, so inge irundhu start panni or cycle motion move agudhu appadina enna aagum, idu center la move aagi indha corner poiittu, then again it is coming to this end, again it is moving. So when it completes one cycle, that is circular motion, it completes with a one oscillatory motion. Okay, one circular motion and one oscillatory motion are equal. Yes, clear with this?